Are you worried about the side effects from all the prescription medications that you're taking? Right now, you're going to hear why a holistic approach to healing can create miracles in your life.
Today's Health with Dr. Troy of Synaptic Chiropractic in Vancouver, Washington. Now here is my dad, Dr. Troy.
I've got a great show in store for you today. I've brought a lot of information into the studio, and I want to share that information with you. I recently wrote a newsletter in my office entitled "What is going on around here?" And I just kind of want to start our show off today, just describing to you what it is that we do in our office, and really what our mission is for our community. Not only just that, but the people in our community, and really across the U.S. and our country, and even reaching out into the rest of the world. In the last few months, a few things have become more and more clear to me as we continue entering this fast-paced, busy world. We, as average Americans, are getting sicker and sicker and sicker. And I always ask patients, I'm like, how are we doing with our health as Americans? How are we doing? And every single time, you know, I had a patient the other night, he's like, we're just sicker now than ever. And in the last few months, I have seen some of the sickest patients I've ever seen in my last 13 years of practicing specific scientific chiropractic care. People and families in our community, in Vancouver and Portland, across, you know, Oregon and Washington, they're hurting more and more than ever, and they really have no idea what to do. That is why I get on the radio. Patients asked me, this lady asked me the other day, she says, why do you always share the negatives about medicines and vaccination and all these stats on death and dying? You know, don't you just fix bad backs? Isn't that really what you do? You're just a bad back doctor. And my answer is like, are you kidding me? I said, don't you understand that the treatment of sickness and disease with medication and surgical procedures is the number one cause of death in America? Don't you get that? I'm like, don't you understand that that kills more Americans than heart disease or cancer? I'm like, I'm not just a bad back doctor. I'm here to share the information that literally can save people's lives. And, you know, somebody's dying every 30 seconds because of medicine. That's what the stats say. That's what the Journal of the American Medical Association says. And it's like every 30 seconds, someone's dying from that treatment or that condition or that disease. That's not okay with me. Everywhere you look and every patient I meet, guess what? They don't want to be on medication. They don't want to have unneeded surgeries. But the question is, what are you doing to avoid it? And the answer for most people is not a darn thing. And it's not necessarily their fault, but it ultimately leads to that. But guess what the medical model says that we should do with our health? They say that we should only go to the doctor when we what? When we have symptoms, when we have a back pain or a neck pain or, you know, bleeding ulcer or different things. We have a headache or we have chronic pain or we have arthritis. We go in to the medical provider. What do? They diagnose us, meaning they put a label on whatever condition it is, right? And I'm not about not finding out if you have a disease or cancer or anything like that, but just this is what we've been trained to do. Hey, I'll do nothing until what? It gets really bad or I can't breathe or I have to call 911 and they're wheeling me into the ER room on the gurney. And this is when people hit the reality of, I should have taken better care of myself. So in the medical model, it says if you have a symptom, condition, or whatnot, you do what? You do medication. You throw a medication at it. You throw some sort of chemical at it. And if the chemical doesn't work, sometimes it might, sometimes it doesn't. In many cases, it doesn't. And you throw the chemical at it. What happens if it doesn't work? You go back to the doctor or you call the doctor and they up your dosage, right? That's one scenario. Or they change medications. And if that doesn't work, then what's next? And some of you listening to this show, you've been on the medical merry-go-round, meaning you go to doctor after doctor after doctor, and they keep doing the same thing over and over again. More medication, change the dosage. Ooh, let's go off-label. And I don't know if any of you know what off-label is. That's where they really don't know what the drug will, there's no studies on, let's say, for example, you go in for a high blood pressure and they're like, well, we've tried these other high blood pressure drugs that we've done studies that actually have lowered blood pressure. But why don't we try this antidepressant, for example? And we've just known that some people have had a lower blood pressure, but there's no studies. It's off label. So there's no studies that really describe what that is. That's another option. Or if that doesn't work, then we do some sort of surgery to, try to alleviate those conditions. So in the medical model, it's drugs and surgery to alleviate condition. That's the definition of medicine. It's doing treatment with drugs and surgery to alleviate conditions. So my question to you is, what is health in that scenario? What is health? Wow, interesting. Because that is my job as a maximized living provider, is to show you how to have a maximized life the way God designed us to. Do you think God said, you know what, I'm going to design Americans to have high blood pressure, to be overweight, to have diabetes, to have chronic depression, to have arthritis throughout their whole body, to have ravaging amounts of cancer? I think not. I think that is what, the devil's gotten in there and allowed us to do that. But God's body was designed perfectly to live to be 120, 130 years of age without cancer, without heart disease, without diabetes, without depression, without fatigue, without, aches and pains like we have, without being tired all the time, without having all these weird symptomatologies. And so, when I deal with patients, that's the hardest thing to get them to do is step outside of that model that we've been taught by our parents, by the TV, by drug ads, by our doctors. Our job as maximized living providers is to show you the path God has lined out for you and your health and your wellness. I can't tell you how many times I've had people that just, they pray and pray and pray because they keep going to all these doctors and getting sicker and sicker and sicker. And then somebody shows them our office. That's why I get on the radio and have a show, is so that people can understand that there's hope, that there's life, and there's healing that's available, but you can't do it inside that medical model. And not to say that the medical model is bad. The medical model is really, really awesome at emergency crisis care. Right? You get in an accident, you crash your motorcycle, break some bones, they're going to rush you to the ER. They're going to save your life. Clearly that's the best part of medicine on the planet. Any country, we are the best in emergency crisis care. But for restoring and regaining health, that medical model is a failing model. It's the worst on the planet. Out of the top 50, World Health Organization said out of the top 50 healthcare industries, it is the worst model. So what is it that we do? What do we teach? I had a guy yesterday, give you a story. He, John comes in and I'm like, John, why are you wearing slippers, buddy? And John's an older guy. He's in his 60s and pushing 70. And he's like, well, I just got out of the hospital. I'm like, oh my gosh, John, you've been coming here for 2 years. And you've been a patient regularly for 2 years. Why? I'm sitting there, some of you listening go, why would he be a patient in a chiropractor office for 2 years? Well, the purpose is to maintain the function of his nerve system, because that's where the healing and that's where the health comes from. But recently he had a visit to his medical provider, his medicine provider, and they provided him some cholesterol lowering drugs because he had high cholesterol, and they lowered his cholesterol. And they also lowered his function of his kidneys. His kidneys actually shut down. So he spent a week in the hospital. I was telling a nurse this yesterday, and she's like, that's normally not the case. It's normally the liver with those cholesterol-lowering drugs. Well, in his case, his kidneys shut down. And I said, John, the problem isn't high cholesterol. The problem is what else you're doing to your body. And I said, no, we're keeping your nerve system working, but there's something else you're doing to jack up that cholesterol, and we're going to find out the cause of it, right? We're not going to go, let's just treat the effect. Let's go to the cause. What is causing your cholesterol to go up? And I was telling him, I said, cholesterol is protection. That is protection. A good friend of mine has Lyme's disease. He goes to his regular medical doctor, like, oh my gosh, your cholesterol is through the roof. You need Lipitor. You need these cholesterol lowering drugs. And Greg, he's like, that doesn't make sense to me. So he goes to this guy who specializes in Lyme's disease. And the guy's like, that is the last thing you want to do is lower that cholesterol with Lyme's disease, because that cholesterol is protecting your nerve system. Do you guys realize that 60 to 70% of your brain is made of cholesterol? So let's lower that. What are you actually doing? You're actually sucking the cholesterol out of your brain. That's not really good for health and function. Because remember, as a maximized living doctor, we want your body to function and be as healthy as possible. We don't just want to treat the effects of symptomatology with chemicals and see what happens. So anyway, so I said, John, we're going to find you this book. There's this other thing you can do to change your diet. We're going to start working on this to show you how to healthy your happier life. That's what we do in our office. Recently, I just had a last couple stories I had. We had a patient told me, but she was told by two medical doctors she would not be alive by next Christmas. She's now alive and well thanks to specific scientific chiropractic care. A one-year-old with chronic ear infections, breathing problems. He is facing surgery, tubes in his ears. He was on multiple medications since birth. He's now functioning perfectly. I've been working on him 2 weeks with specific scientific chiropractic care. So some of you sitting here, you know you're suffering from low energy, fatigue. You've had multiple symptoms. You've got fibromyalgia. By the way, that's just the label. You've got these things that you've been labeled as. You've got tired all the time, depression, you're stiff, your energy's not right, you can't sleep good, you've got numbness and tingling. You are the one that needs to call our office, schedule a time to see us. Normally, when you come to our office, we evaluate you. We do a case history. We take really specific digital x-rays to see right where the bones of your spine have shifted out of alignment and they're starting to choke off the nerves. We're the only doctors trained to look for this. So earlier we were talking about the maximized living model versus the medical model. And in the medical model, you know, it's everywhere we look that our health is becoming worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. And, you know, I was asking patients the other day, I said, where do doctors get their training from? Where do most of them get their training from? They get them from, you know, a medical college and, or like, for example, Oregon Health Science University. But where does funding come in many cases? Who teaches? And, you know, who teaches these things? So one thing you have to understand is doctors are taught typically by instructors or colleges. And guess where they get funding? They get them from drug companies. They get them from companies that make devices, surgical devices or implants. So that their money comes from these companies that actually, you know, will fund their teaching so that they can teach how to use their products, if you will. One of the things Time Magazine earlier in the year, they did a front cover article that says what doctors hate most about hospitals. And it was an insider view of what can go wrong and how you can improve your chance of getting the right treatment. The question, the front page of this headline, it says, what scares doctors the most? Guess what? Being the patient. That's what scares doctors the most. And it's interesting to go, wow. Amazing to think that being the patient, that scares doctors the most. And I was looking at U.S. News and World Report. This is front cover. They had Bernadine Healy, who was the director of the Red Cross. She's a medical doctor. This is April 9th issue. Her headline was Cancer and Me. It was interesting because she wrote a thing that says this cancer, she actually had a brain tumor. She said this cancer was insidious, having grown to a near fatal state without ever tipping me off. Wow. You know, people think, well, I don't have a bad back. I don't have a bad neck. You know, why would I go to a chiropractor? So that we can show you how to keep your body functioning to its maximum for the rest of your life. Because the thing is her husband, they read Fred, he said, he put it simply, he says, I want my wife back. I mean, what would Fred pay to get his wife back? What would Fred pay to help prevent that cancer? What would Fred pay to keep her, you know, in the game of life and health and healing? I want to suggest that he would probably do just about anything. He would drive as far as he could. He would pay whatever we could. He would stop, you know, drinking and smoking and eating pizzas on the weekends. He'd stop going out to dinners. He'd sell his cars. He'd do whatever he could to get his wife back to normal. And, you know, the thing is, I don't want any of you to go through that. And I know some of you have experienced family members who've had cancer or heart disease or have lost them. But the key is you got to have someone who is teaching the maximized living model. And it's interesting, trends in alternative medicine. I don't really like that word alternative medicine because chiropractic isn't an alternative to medicine. Chiropractic is a way of life. Alternatives to medicine would be naturopathy. That is an alternative to medicine. Chiropractic is a specific healthcare in and of itself. But nonetheless, in 1990, there was 427 million visits to alternative healthcare providers, chiropractors being the majority of them. And 7 years later, the number doubled. In 1997, out-of-pocket expenses for alternative providers was around $27 billion. That's how much people were spending out of their pocket to go outside this medical model. And it was interesting to look at this thing that says, compared to the beneficial effects of what a wellness-based chiropractor can offer with the rest of what they lump into alternative therapies, we are absolutely the most qualified profession to be leading the mass from the allopathic sickness to the holistic natural wellness care model. People are recognizing the value of wellness, taking care of the body, and they're willing to do what? They're willing to pay for it. Those of you who go, well, if my insurance doesn't pay for it, you know what? You're going to stay right in that medical model because that is part of it. You need to find a provider. That's what we do. We make care affordable so you don't have to use the medical model. You can stay healthy. And then, you know what? It's there for a backup in case you need it. BJ Palmer says, medical men have always searched the world for remedies, desiring an antidote. Chiropractors find the cause in that ailing person. BJ Palmer also said, he said, in the future, this is over 60, 70 years ago, in the future, chiropractor will be valued for its preventative qualities. Do you hear that? For its preventative qualities as much as relieving and adjusting the cause of ailments. Bill Koch, he's a chiropractor back in the early 50s. Only when the collective consciousness shifts can we expect to have a healthy population. That's why I get on the radio and share this information, because I'm encouraging you and your family and your loved ones in our town and our community is to get that shift in our consciousness. People must change their current lifestyles in favor of a chiropractic lifestyle, not the medical lifestyle, which means wait till you have sickness and disease and show up. The chiropractic lifestyle, which includes good nutrition, exercise, and keeping the nerve system free. Check this out. Chiropractors, and this is interesting, because people go, I've got this disease or that disease. Chiropractors, this is from Dr. Chestnut. He's a medical scientist and a chiropractor up in Canada. Chiropractors do not treat disease. We provide care to human beings. The adjustment is intended to restore normal motion and alignment in the spine and spinal joints. Whether or not this is the cause of disease, it's not relevant. As we understand it as a profession, the normal spinal motion is a prerequisite. Listen to this. Normal spinal motion is a prerequisite for normal brain and nerve system function. Wow. Normal brain and nerve. That's what will keep you alive and healthy for as long as God intended you to be. We can feel confident that normalizing spinal joints and motion has a positive effect on the human being as whole. It is possible to improve the function of a human being with or without a disease. Eating a good diet is ideal whether you have cancer or not. Right? Whether you have cancer, whether your cancer is cured for not from eating a good diet is an illogical measure of the benefit of a good diet. We just know from deductive logic that any chance at health is better with a balanced diet than without. The same can be said about normal function of the spine, spinal joints, and related tissues as it's related to the nerve pathways that are positively affected by the chiropractic adjustment. You see, that's why people need to be under regular chiropractic care, whether they have symptoms or not. Whether they have a cancer or not, whether they have headaches or not, because a healthy functioning nerve system is what runs and controls everything. Interesting. I was reading shareholders file a class action lawsuit against Eli Lilly. And it was interesting. You guys have to understand what you're up against here is we know that medicine is now one of the biggest killers in America. Eli Lilly's shareholders sued them because they claim the company falsely and misled people concerning this blockbuster drug, their best-selling product, is Zyprexa, because they knew, the drug company knew, there was a clear link between Zyprexa and diabetes, yet they failed to warn the public. I would be scared about any chemical that you're sticking in your body, because there are direct effects and there are direct effects. They're not side effects. They're direct effects. You're just hoping that Zyprexa will be an antidepressant, but it's causing diabetes. What else does Eli Lilly sell? They sell insulin. Wow. So now they take Zyprexa, it causes more diabetics. They sell more insulin. And they went on to say that they were engaging in illicit off-label marketing programs. And the bottom line is they failed to inform people. They knew these drugs were causing damage in people. You know what's beautiful about what we do is there's no direct effects. There's no side effects. There's only your body functioning at a higher level. The Journal of Hypertension came out with a study comparing chiropractic to blood pressure drugs. And chiropractic is not a treatment for high blood pressure. But what they found is people who are under regular chiropractic care, on average, compared to these drugs, had a lower blood pressure. I had Don, he's a patient of mine. His wife sent him in. The guy's been, he's like, I never go to chiropractic. I don't have a bad back, but he had high blood pressure. He's like, well, I'm going to go to chiropractic and find out. Guy's got a stressful job. And I'm looking at him. I'm like, what's causing his blood pressure? A stressful job. I'm like, all right, Don, you need to start exercising. How's that been going? Not too good. How's your nutrition? Not too good. How's your spine functioning? Not too good. So we start doing these three things. It's been 2 weeks now. And guess what? He's like, oh, that feels so good. What do you think that does to his stress when he's like, ah, that feels good? It reduces it. Could you see how that possibly could affect the way your blood pressure, your heart, your nerve system functions? I just had a really good patient of mine. He's a realtor. His wife and are good friends with one of their clients, and they were telling me about this 1-year-old son they had. The guy's been in and out of the hospital. He's had multiple surgeries. He's on multiple medications at only a year old. He's on 6 different medications. Could you imagine that? Could you imagine your 1-year-old being on 6 different medications in and out of the hospital? They've literally spent hundreds of thousands of dollars maxing out their insurance for all these medical procedures. And I said, I told Gary, we need to get the little boy checked. He's like, I'm going to have you call them and see what we can do. And you know what? That's what it's about. It's about, let's get them checked to see what they can do. And one of the things they said is they're like, we can't afford to go to the chiropractor. I'm like, you can't afford not to. I had another one that same thing. She's been coming in for 2 weeks. Little boy's cleared up of all these things. She'd spent thousands of dollars in the hospital. So I'm just urging you, if you have kids, if you have family members, grandparents, parents, loved ones, spouse, friends, aunts and uncles that are suffering, that that they've just tried everything, I'm going to urge you to call our office. 877-4 Dr. Troy.
To see if chiropractic is right for you, we are offering a chiropractic neurological evaluation, spinal x-ray analysis, and a customized report of findings with a healing game plan, all for $47.
Thank you for joining Dr. Troy Dreiling for Today's Health. That phone number again is 877-4-DR-TROY. That's 877-4-DR-TROY. Or visit Dr. Troy online at ZynaptikChiropractic.com.